How did we
Okay, I'll think.
No, okay.
We met.
No, listen, okay.
You explained that.
Yeah, Tina. Listen, okay. This is how we met. Okay, so we've known each other actually for a long time. I've known Carson since I was 13 years old.
No. I've known you.
Okay, so the truth is I didn't really know who he
was. That's right.
Maybe 15 I knew who he was. And he was always a cute little kid with, he had like these red wings, like Justin Bieber, but just a redhead version. He was always so nice.
Very shy.
Really shy though. So we didn't really know each other that well until high school. He was kind of in our same friend group in high school, and he started just dating all of my friends. And that's when I started to get so mad. Oh, wait.
I had to play the game. I had to go after the friends to get her attention.
Yeah, little did I know he's very strategic in how he asked me out. Yeah. Finally went out on our first date, and things just clicked after that. So we were high school sweethearts up until we graduated, and then Carson decided to go on an LDS mission to Romania
for two years,
and we still wrote each other every Monday, and then we Skyped each other on Christmas and
Mother's Day.
And so we kept in touch for those 2 years, and I went to LA to pursue my career in dance. And
I wasn't even here the year she won with Alfonso, the mirror ball. So I didn't even get to see that.
Yeah, I did send you videos, didn't I?
Send you videos.
I sent him videos and pictures and stuff like that. But, you know, we weren't sure if it was going to work out when he came home, and we were kind of skeptical. So our first date, when he came home, I took him to a grocery store.
So I walk in there, and I'm thinking she's taking me to a grocery store to eat our first meal after 2 years of being apart.
Yeah.
And I'm like walking around
of fruit.
Trying to find something to eat. And I don't want to be like a pig with all these like chips and drinks, and that's all that I thought there was there. So I'm like, well, I'll play it safe with a cup of fruit.
It was bad. It was the most awkward first date ever, because it felt like we still knew each other, but we were so, like, things had changed so much. I think after a few more dates, it started to get a little bit more comfortable, and then I invited him to Cancun with my family.
And that sealed the deal.
Yeah, that was the trip that, like, we really knew that, like, we were meant for each other and that we wanted to get married to each other. And then 6 months later, we were engaged. 3 months after that, we were married. We just didn't waste any time.
No need. It's right, you know?
What I really love about Carson is his positivity and how fun he is. He always makes any situation positive and fun. And I think for me, I really need that. In all seriousness, that's what I love. He just has a love for life that I just love that, because it makes everything so much more fun.
There's too many things I'm trying to pinpoint. Like my favorite thing about Whitney, there's too many to name one, but I think her caringness. She cares for so many people around her, including myself, which I'm kind of needy sometimes.
Yeah.
Okay. Whoa. Don't agree to that. You can say no. I'm kind of needy. I need a lot of attention, and she's so caring, and she truly does put me first, even over herself, and that is very special to me about her.
Thanks.
On October 2nd, 2015, I flew all my sisters and my mom out to LA, because it was a girls' trip, and I secretly flew there as well. During that day of October 2nd, me and my dad, Doug, we calculated out like the cubic feet that we removed of sand. It was like 16,000 pounds of sand. It took forever. Anyways, and that night, the girls were taking a walk on the beach, and I was there waiting with the surprise little canopy in the sand with like a little couch and a sitting area, and I proposed to her.
It was honestly the cutest thing I've ever seen. And I was so surprised because I had no idea that he was there.
It was a girls' trip.
Yeah, it was a girls' trip. So I was planning on dinner with all of his sisters and his mom and my mom and sister. And so I wasn't expecting him at all. That's one of my favorite moments ever in my whole life, was when he proposed to me, because it was just so special, and it was at sunset, and it was just me and him and his family. And
our wedding was super cold, freezing
cold. -8 degrees. It really just goes by so fast, and you just can't even really take it all in. So I'm glad that we got to split it up in 2 days, because then the first day we could really focus on just him and I. And then the second day kind of was for everybody else. And it was amazing to see all of the support that we had there, and just other than the fact that it was freezing cold. Our life right now is a little crazy. We're going back and forth from LA to Utah, and he's kind of just following me around.
Yeah. Oh, freak! When are we gonna have kids? Say it on the count of three. One, two, three.
Never.
Oh my gosh.
We don't know, but we just kind of have to play it by ear because everything's so crazy right now. It's like we're not really settled at all, but we do want kids. Carson is a kid magnet, no joke.
It's only because I'm like a human jungle gym.
Yeah.
How many kids?
I think we want 3 or 4 would be a safe number to say.
No more than 4. As long as we get one of both genders, I'll be happy.
Yeah.
What's important to me
in a good relationship,
would be probably service that shows true love and also builds the love that's already there.
And also being able to like trust and communicate with one another, because we're not perfect at all. And there's things that, you know, in order to build that good relationship, you always have to be, you know, partners. You have to be companions to each other and love and trust one another and communicate how you're feeling and you know, making sure that your goals align, I think for us is a big one too. Like, what do we want in this life that's most important to us? And that's, you know, building a great family with good standards and good beliefs and
putting each other first, definitely.
Yeah, putting each other first. It's also hard with my career. It's like, it's so important and so stressful, and you know, we're trying to make that a priority, but at the end of the day, you know, family is most important. And so I think for us, like over these 2 years, we've kind of really tried to make that a point and really important, that we always put one another first and one another's needs before our own. So.